Okay, hey, this is Thegamemanic here. we were watching Black vs. Me and my friend TJ here, watching Black vs. Credits video, and
I'm getting no service.
We were looking at, you can use my phone. We were looking at Alan Austin's video. I mean, my bad. We were looking at his video on, what is it? In Your Boy. And so what we decided to do was, one of his friends, one of Key Master Review's friends, Alan Austin here, we decided to look at his shit, and we found out he put it in that little post-it that Black Blessed Credit put on it, and he actually put his phone number, his address, and so we found his phone number, and my friend's right now is calling him. Hey, are you seriously calling him? Yeah, he's calling him. He's calling him. Shit's about to go down. Put it on speaker. All right, turn this shit down. So they can't trust enough.
Hello?
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 Hello? Is Austin Allen there?
Who's calling?
Well, I'm just hearing a friendly warning here. He posted his address onto a YouTube video. And you should probably tell him that's not a smart thing to do. Like, within moments, I was basically able to go onto, type in his address in the name that he gave, and find this number through his church pamphlet, which was like the first link on Google.
What?
Yeah, you should tell him that's not a good thing to do.
Who is this?
This is just an internet user, ma'am. You should tell him to not do this. This is a bad thing to do.
Okay, so hopefully she actually listens, and hopefully she talks to Austin about
shit.
This. Because, you know, apparently you can't just be putting in your address and your name on the internet. Check this out here.
This is what you fucking
around
fam.
Here. Come around here. Yeah. Look at this here. See this?
No.
We got the name.
Let's see.
We got the address.
Okay, huh. Damn.
Way over here. We hit enter.
And this is...
That's it, right there.
Oh, no. And show them the proof. Go back to this video. Go back to Blockbuster's video.
Right here.
He puts it in there, and all we did was look at the fucking comment. Now, you can't see it because the goddamn lighting sucks on this camera, but still. He put it in the fucking comment.
It was simple. We
And we just
it.
Called his fucking...
We had the address.
Oh,
we had the name.
This is fucking stupid.
I didn't have to type all the address. 4677 Laurel.
Oh, yeah, and by the way, we didn't...
We found it right here.
And the number he called, we didn't use our actual... They can't trace the number, just letting y'all know that. I'm straight.
We went here.
This is fucking stupid!
This week's headlines, we found it. We even went down here. Name's here.
No.
They have, like, the number.
Yeah, this is a church pamphlet from his church, because all we did was type in his fucking address, because you dumb-ass motherfuckers. And then you get mad!
You don't do this stuff. You don't put your address and your name on the internet.
You can't do this shit. This is fucking retarded. And you wonder why.
Like, really, you can just find people with Google. And then you don't want to have your address and your name out there because you don't know what your address and your name are on. His address and name are on this pamphlet. He probably never thought about this. He probably never even knew this pamphlet was on the internet. But it's on there. He gave us a name. He gave us the address. His name and address were in here because he got baptized and they put in the pamphlet. Google found it.
This is in moments. And this is the ultimate fail, folks.
We called right there, phone number. I assume that may have been his mother,
probably his mom.
Wife, sister, I don't know. Picked up. Hopefully she's talking to him right now, telling him to not do this stuff. Because that's how you mess some stuff up.
Seriously, what the fuck?
Some of our more informed internet users know about 4chan. You know what 4chan will do if they get access to information like this.
Yo, dog, I heard you like Mookie.
Seriously. Can't be screwing up like that.
This is fucking sad.
That's a new internet mistake right there.
And I'm just gonna do a real quick comment on this whole Inyo boy, because this is where we got this. That's where we got the information from. From this fucking video. The third part of the one Blockbuster has just put out a few days ago. It's been like a day, actually, if not a few hours ago. You can't do this shit. And dude, you get mad that he contacted your parents and that he knows all your information. Motherfucker, you put it on the internet. You knew. Listen, there isn't
four seconds.
Okay, listen.
This is not a long search. I didn't have to go
every time you upload a video, It's the user agreement. You agree that every... And you have the option to choose if people can look at your shit. And you let them look at your shit.
The moment you put something on the internet, it becomes public property in a sense. If you don't have that locked under a password. Even then, there are hackers, if they're good enough, can get in that. But at least you have it under a password. You tried to prevent it. You got legal action going then. You can actually probably sue someone. But right there, if you go, hey, look, you can find me. My name is Austin Allen. I live here. Okay.
And plus
Google,
that,
your name is Austin Allen. You live here. This is your church. This is your phone number. You know what? If I actually went in, did a little bit more in-depth Google foo right there, I could probably find out who he's related to. I could find out where he is. People living at. Like, assume I was, like, a threat to him somehow. That would be horrible. Like, assume someone, like, had a death wish on this man and his family. He just gave them his address, his phone number. Do you know what you can do with a phone number? Look at what we just did with a name and an address. Had we just had an address, okay, it's an address. We don't know if that's a real address. You gave a name. Not a fake name, a real name. Real name, real address, Google. 4 seconds. First post on the first page. Found a phone number. Not hard to do at all.
This is fucking sad. And, I mean, in the video, he's already exposed this in your boy for, what is his name, Brandon, what is it? Brandon Kennedy, I think? Yeah, yeah. Brandon Kennedy. And we searched this shit on MySpace. And it's not from the links. We looked at his, we got his grandfather. And under his grandfather is him. And then you know
it's
how,
simple.
You know how we figured it out? For one, he put his information on his MySpace. Two, his fucking face is on the MySpace. And because he's been on YouTube, we know what the fuck he looks like.
You don't do this. You don't throw this information out there on the internet.
This is fucking stupid. I don't understand. And why are you shocked?
If you're famous, if you're an actor, a rapper, a basketball player, football player, soccer player, singer, dancer, and your name still gets out there, okay, that's expected. People are going to know your name. But have you noticed something here? One celebrity loses their cell phone, their BlackBerry, and someone gets their addresses and all that stuff, do you know what happens? They call everyone on that file list and uploads to the internet. And do you see the havoc that causes? Now imagine if someone disliked you.
And wanted to kill you.
Yeah. And you see, okay, matter of fact, we're about to quote right here. What's in this post here. Austin Allen 94. Bitch, shut the fuck up, nigga. This his bra. Fuck with him again. I'ma bet your ass. Not beat, cause parents cannot spell. I'ma bet your ass on my fucking life. I'ma shit out you dumbass. Faga equal sign. Tory ass bitch make a video about me. And see if I don't respond. Oh, tell your ma to get off my dick, nigga. Bitch, you can find me at. Put his address right there. Oh, the name is Austin Allen. Bitch. Right there. Address. Name.
Fail. Epic fail. And this comes from Inu Boy too.
Let's assume Blockbuster Critic wasn't just some YouTube video person. Let's say he had connections to, I don't know. Let's say he knew where to get guns, weapons, bombs. Let's say he knows how to make a bomb.
Technically, you can get that shit anywhere nowadays, which is
really you could. Let's say he knew how to make a bomb. Address. We already verified that it is actually his
actual address. Actually, yeah, look. Because I think it fits the goddamn theme right now. Because he has access and he can virtually kill this nigga now, even though he wants to make threats and shit. He can literally kill this nigga. And I'm gonna explain how. Well, I'm not gonna explain how, but this is the perfect music you would use right now.
Listen, he won. Victory fanfare, right there.
That's it. I don't even need to finish it. That's it.
Let's say he knew how to make a bomb.
Address, you are name, fuck Austin Allen verified. At such an. Actually, at fucking 4677 Laurel Leaf Street.
Yeah.
And what state is that?
We found the state because we went to the pamphlet.
We know where the fuck, we know what state you actually, I want to verify this shit.
If I remember right, it was Tennessee.
You live in Memphis, Tennessee. You fucking fail. You
number.
Fucking, nigga.
Well, look, we learned he was a youth, which means he's probably 18 or under if he's counted as a youth. We found out he was baptized October 18th.
You fail.
We just got this information. Google. First result.
In like 4 fucking seconds. This?
Result 1 of 10 out of about 2,630. Result 1.
There we gotta end
numero
this.
Uno.
It's about the YouTube has the whole 10 minute video limit, so I gotta turn this off. But just final thoughts here. Black Buzzer Critic, great video. Just, I thought that shit was funny. We ain't finished with it. That's sad.
I know. Yahoo Answers saying, hilarious.
But anyways, eat the internet. Anyway, just think, goddammit. Think.
I know, people, think. You cannot, it is imperative that you do not put your information out on the internet if you don't want people to have it.
And that's how we'll end this. Peace.